Top of the Morning Bay with Good Morning Bay.
Get to know about the traffic on your way and what's news around the world today.
Some wisdom skills along the way.
Oh, and a song to hum along with and sway.
Get your perfect entertaining start to the day.
At 9 a.m. every weekday morning with
Mahima's
Good Morning Bay.
Good morning, bae. आप सभी लोग हमारे तरफ से एक प्यार भरा नमस्ते.
नमस्कार.
वणकम.
नमस्कार.
खुश आमदीद.
सलाम अलैकुम.
सत श्री अकाल.
मी कंद्री की वंदनमु.
जय स्वामी नारायण.
जय श्री कृष्णा.
जय जनेंद्रा.
हमारे इस्माइली भाई बंधु को बोल दे या अली मदद.
मौला अली मदद बोलते हुए सारे फीजी मंदिर को बोलेंगे नीसा बुला बंधु जन. हम आ गए हैं आपके प्यारे महिमा के द्वारे. मैं फालतू बाबा.
And of course, myself, Faltu Rani Barane, aapki Thursday ko thodi aur terrific aur thodi aur mastani bada jane.
That's right, Benjan. Of course, aaj hai Thursday, matlab it is the 392nd day of sheltering in place, Benjan. Why do I keep reminding people of that? Because it's easy for us to forget this and just get back into the grind.
Right.
It's okay. It's okay to get back into the grind. I'm not saying no, but just try to be mindful of the fact that we have to maintain physical distancing for sure, because we're still not out of the woods on this one, Manuja. COVID is still around, as in whatever format it is in. And as you guys know, other parts of the world, are actually experiencing a very bad situation. Maybe India, maybe Europe, right?
Right.
And of course, we might be better off because of the fact that we never depended on JJ. Right, but right now, JJ, kabhi aapne kal suna hoga news which I shared with you guys as to what's happening with the vaccination. There's still no news about that, by the way. We go check out the news and find out more about that for sure. Lekin abhi ke liye aapko jaake hum log dene wale hain ekdam super duper traffic update, which we call Raste Ka Haal Total Saste Mein.
It's time for the Bandhu traffic update. Call us from wherever you are at 408-912-2479.
Manujan, speaking of traffic update, I was just brought to attention. My attention was taken to a particular place in East Bay. There's a huge traffic backup over there. This is actually because of a traffic accident and an overturned vehicle on 580 westbound. East of El Charo Road in Pleasanton area. The right lane is blocked entirely. The backup is all the way until 84. So it's like, you know, it's all the way down towards the 84, which you have exit out there on 580 Badajan. So it is a huge backup there. Watch out to drive very carefully in those regions. Apart from that, I don't see any other traffic incident as such. But the traffic, of course, looking at the overall bird's eye view of it, is pretty much same situation as COVID. So not many people actually on the road. That's a good thing. It's midweek almost, like Thursday. Weather-wise, if you look at it, yes, it's going to be hot. It's not going to be too hot. It's going to be hot, nevertheless, in the upper 60s, 68 in that range, maximum. But tomorrow is going to be even more hotter, but tomorrow we are going to have the in the lower 70s, somewhere like in 71, 72. And as I told you, weekend is going to be nice and hot and toasty. No clouds anywhere, so it's going to be a wonderful thing for us. So aage badhte hain. We have got the traffic update for you. We talked about the news as what's happening with the weather part of Bridget. But right now, we got to go see if Fatwani is ready for us with the updates for us about what's happening locally and in America. How do you think, Fatwani? Are you ready?
Yes, Altu Baba.
All right, Bajan. So here you go. This is the news for you guys. And abhi aap soch rahe honge, oh, nice. That's good. So what is something to celebrate about the vaccination? I don't know. Let's see what Faltrani is going to say for us. Faltrani, take it away.
Are these the headlines that are coming to you, Banajan, from the San Francisco Bay Area Radio D. Hardy Studios live? From the Bay Area, Stanford begins trials with Pfizer vaccine on children under age 5. San Jose approves downtown glass office tower with rooftop gardens. Tesla is issuing an in-car warning to some Model 3 owners about seal defects in the car. In news from across the United States, Bandujan, Derek Chauvin waives his right to testify, rests the case at a murder trial in the Floyd arrest. Former Minneapolis police officer, Minnesota police officer who was charged in the has been charged in the Daunte Wright death, due in court today. A Democratic proposal to expand the U.S. Supreme Court receives lukewarm reception. In fact, Nancy Pelosi is saying that she's not going to support this particular bill to expand the Supreme Court. Also, California, Banujan, and NASA are partnering to launch methane tracking satellite on Mars. And of course, not afraid to shoot, migration raises tension in Texas border town. More on all of this coming up shortly.
And of course, Banujan, all that will come to you guys. If you're going to check it out on news blog, mediamahima.com. Lekin abhi ke liye, Banujan, it's time for us to go and take a look at the gaane ki kira lined up for you guys. Bahut dinon ke baad ye gaana play karne ko mil raha hai, Banujan. It is a Prasoon Joshi lyrics wala, and of course Shankar Ehsaan Loy composition from the movie Bhaag Milka Bhaag. Why Mastak Arjun? Oh my God, 24th the Mastak Arjun is going to meet anyway. So, ajao. Agar malum nahi kya hone wala hai, talent show hone wala hai, Bay Area ka sabse bada talent show hone wala hai yahan pe. Just outside our studio, go check it out. It's called Step Up for Pragnya. And if you are registered, register kar lena. Kuch bhi chalega. Dance karo, sing karo, painting karo, magic show karo, comedy show karo, but show karo definitely on 24th Banjam. Register at pragnya.org. Step Up for Pragnya. This movie starring Farhan Akhtar Banujan, a story, a life story of Milka Singh, and yes, this song of course sung by Divya Kumar. Banujan nata dota sukhata tabhi to fauji kehla tha lyrics aata hai Banujan lekin abhi ke liye hum log uski taraf nahi jayenge. We're going to go towards Father Inaska, the news in detail, because I really want to know what's happening with coronavirus in Banujan. I don't know about you, but let's go check out Father, what's the news in detail for us, please.
Well, Banujan, I'm going to start with the Derek Chauvin trial. Former Minneapolis policeman Derek Chauvin on Thursday waived his right to testify to the jury about his part in the deadly arrest last May of George Floyd, as both sides rested their cases at his murder trial, the most high-profile police misconduct case in decades. I'll invoke my Fifth Amendment privilege today, Chauvin, 45, said in a hearing before the jury was brought in on Thursday morning after briefly removing his mask, referring to the constitutional right against self-incrimination. They were his most extensive remarks since his trial began with the jury selection on March 8th. The defense told Hennepin County District Judge Peter Cahill that it would call no more witnesses after 2 days of testimony and rested its case. Similarly, let me give you an update on another police misconduct case, Banujan. One of the police officers in the Dante Wright death. So, former Minnesota police officer has been charged with manslaughter in the fatal shooting of Dante Wright. A 20-year-old black man during a traffic stop was scheduled to make her first court appearance on Thursday. If you remember, she had said that she mistook her gun for her taser or something like that. She was trying to reach for her taser, but she actually shot him by mistake. Prosecutors actually are saying that they will try to show that Kim Potter, who's 48 years old, was culpably negligent and took an unreasonable risk in shooting Wright after pulling him over for expired license plates in the Minneapolis suburb of Brooklyn City, Brooklyn Center on Sunday. Can you imagine Altu Baba getting shot and dying?
I know. Many of us actually have been through the period of expired license plates. I don't know. I've been pulled over twice for it.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, because sometimes the DMV doesn't send it to us, right, on time. So it happens to anybody and everybody.
And just for sometimes that, you just don't put the sticker.
Yeah, and sticker might have fallen off also.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, but the thing is, with the many things, and that's what we're talking about. Why? And it's so disturbing to see that there's so much of fear in people nowadays.
Yeah.
Yeah, anyways, what else we have?
So, she, if convicted of a second-degree manslaughter charge, Potter, who is white, faces a maximum sentence of 10 years in prison and a $20,000 fine. Potter, who resigned on Tuesday after 26 years on the force, is due to appear in Hennepin County Courthouse at 1:30 p.m. today. Her lawyer, Earl Grey, did not respond to a request for comment by news reporters. Also, let's tell you, a Democratic proposal to expand the U.S. Supreme Court gets very lukewarm reception. A group of liberal Democratic lawmakers on Thursday proposed expanding the Supreme Court by four justices, aiming to end its conservative majority. But the plan drew an unenthusiastic response from some of the top Democrats and was actually denounced by Republicans. Senator Ed Markey and House of Reps member Gerald Nadler, Hank Johnson and Mondaire Jones introduced legislation in both chambers that would expand the number of justices to 13 from the current 9. Markey said the measure would restore balance to the court. Republican former President Donald Trump had been able to appoint 3 justices, if you remember, just during his 4 years in office, giving the court a 6-3 conservative majority. Senate Republicans have completely politicized the court, undermined its legitimacy, and threatened the rights of millions of Americans, Markey said in a statement. President Joe Biden, a Democrat, last Friday established a bipartisan commission to study potential Supreme Court changes, including expansion or imposing term limits on justices instead of the current lifetime appointments. Biden gave the commission 180 days to report its findings. U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, on the other hand, has said that she does not support proposed legislation to add seats to the U.S. Supreme Court and favors President Joe Biden's approach of having a bipartisan commission study potential court reforms. That's the latest that's coming out from there. From California, Manajan, California and NASA, with the backing of billionaire Mike Bloomberg, on Thursday unveiled a $100 million effort to pinpoint large emissions of greenhouse gases from individual sources like power plants and oil refineries from space. The partnership between the state, U.S. Space Agency, satellite company Planet, and 4 other institutions will launch its first 2 satellites in 2023. The technology could help increase pressure on polluting industries already targeted by environmental activists and investors for their contribution to climate change to find and plug leaks. And in some tension across Texas, Banajan, there is migrants from Haiti have started arriving at the Val Verde Humanitarian Coalition after being released by the U.S. CBP. The officers there are saying that they are not afraid to shoot people. Wow. Migrants from entering illegally as well. In local news, Banajan, Tesla is some owners of Tesla Model 3s have received an in-car notification from the company warning them that defective seals on the vehicles could result in water getting into the cabin, according to a report Thursday from Electrek. The affected vehicles have a vehicle identification number between 910,000 and 917,000, and several Tesla owners in Germany reported getting an in-car notification on their screen saying they need to bring their car in for service, according to Electrek. Social media groups are now offering expertise in tracking down vaccine appointments. With the largest pool of Californians now able to access vaccines, Banajan, 16 and up, some may be finding it harder to land an appointment. But an online community launched in the Bay Area may be able to help. Some people trying to land a coveted COVID-19 vaccination appointment are turning to specialized Facebook groups such as San Francisco COVID-19 Vaccine Help. Administrators offer their expertise to others after they become fairly skilled at snatching up appointments for family members early on in the vaccination eligibility period. And of course, the Facebook group has more than 5,700 members. So the group is San Francisco COVID-19 Vaccine Help and is updated frequently with openings for vaccines in San Francisco and in surrounding areas. In news from San Jose, a big change is coming to San Jose skyline. The San Jose City Council just approved what looks like a cluster of 4 glass towers, the tallest standing 18-story building. Where is it going to be happening? Well, we'll bring you more updates on that tomorrow right here on Good Morning Bay. And Stanford, Bunajan, has started their trials, vaccination trials. The next critical step in reaching herd immunity is being able to vaccinate children. And Stanford announced that this process is underway already. They announced it yesterday. It's part of a trial with Pfizer to test COVID-19 vaccine on children under the age of 5. And there's a 3-year-old who is also part of this anticipated trial. And the parents of that child have spoken about this particular trial. And they say, we know that getting herd immunity is a big part of getting back to whether normal, how normal will look like in the future. So that's the reason that they have enrolled their child in the trial as well. Those were the headlines and news in detail from across the United States and the Bay Area. Aldababa, did you want any updates on what's going on across the world?
I would love to, but a quick reminder to everybody out there, this would have been the tax day, right? April 15th, but actually it's been moved out for by a month. So this is something which is could be a sigh of relief for many people actually are scampering right now to finish your taxes and everything. It's gone to May 17th, the deadline right now, the new deadline. The other changes also, by the way, it's not just the deadline of submission. There's also things about your extension. If somebody wants to apply for extension, you could do it before the May 17th and you actually automatically get a 5-month extension is what they're saying. And apart from that, Manjan, there are also other things which is in terms of, you know, if your questions is about how you want to, whether you want to take a IRA right now, whatever it is, Manjan, you can do it right now because you have one more month, right? Pretty much until May 17th. Go do it right now. Do not procrastinate, Banjan. Don't be like me. Definitely make sure you get the paperwork in place in time and get it done right away. Yeah, you have a month's time, so don't rush about it anyways, Banjan. So enjoy this particular day anyways. It's a gift for us. Yeah, some people actually asked about even state taxes. Even that probably will be postponed. So just look out for it and make sure you are in your... checking out about these things on the news blog mediamahima.com. Now we'll jump into the world news with our Faltwani. So directly, are you going to jump into the world news, Faltwani, for us?
Yes, Altamala, we could go directly to that. Let me start with the news from India, Banajan. Indian farmers are vowing to carry on a months-long protest despite concerns over the coronavirus. Thousands of Indian farmers who have been protesting over 3 new agricultural laws that they say threaten their livelihoods have vowed to continue their around-the-clock sit-ins despite a sharp rise in coronavirus cases in the country. Speaking of the sharp rise in coronavirus cases, they're saying the variants are the ones that are actually stoking the highest increase in coronavirus cases in the country. Altababa, Indian hospitals are battling a chaotic surge as daily virus infections surge over 200,000.
Wow.
Yeah, many Indian hospitals have been scrambling for beds and oxygen as COVID-19 infections surge to a new daily record on Thursday, with the second wave of infections centered on the rich western state of Maharashtra. In Delhi, in fact, there are 2 people to a bed, apparently, in a Delhi hospital as India's COVID crisis is spiraling out of control. Worries are that restrictions imposed by Indian states to curb a rapid surge in coronavirus cases has disrupted supply chains, hit freight networks, and has caused labor shortages in small companies that make up a third of the economic output, business owners are saying. And they're saying this could have a devastating impact on the economy, not just the Indian economy, but also Asia Pacific, and the world economy as well. In other news that's coming out from across the world, Banujan, the United States has imposed a wide array of sanctions on Russia for maligning actions. The United States imposed this for, in fact, they went to the extent of saying that the Russian intelligence was in fact responsible for cyber hacking and bullying Ukraine and other malign acts, and they have imposed a broad array of sanctions on Russia to punish it for alleged interference in the 2020 US election.
You know what's interesting, Valdwani?
Yeah.
The reporters, the media, how they're reporting right now.
How?
If it were to be Trump doing this, they say Trump did this, Trump did that. Now it's like, you know, they're not saying Biden at all. They say US is doing that.
That's true.
I don't know if people have noticed it, but just critical thinking, karo thoda. See how biased the media is.
How is it biased? Why are you not giving credit to President Joe Biden?
It's not a question of credit. Okay, so you're saying the President Joe Biden actually gave the headlines to the media?
No.
Then?
It's the United States president. Where over there, it was United States president.
So the media was unnecessarily tracking him and they were trying to make him a villain, right?
Oh, my God.
They were targeting Trump. Anyways, we know Trump is out of the question right now. But okay, I just want to tell Bandhus to be more cautious in the read stuff. Don't just believe in the first instance. Go deeper. Dig deeper.
So Japanese Prime Minister Yoshihide Suga and US President Joe Biden will highlight Tokyo's central role in Washington's strategy to counter the challenge of an increasingly assertive China at a summit on Friday. Now, China, on the other hand, has summoned Japan and the Japanese ambassador over plans to release contaminated Fukushima water into sea.
Say it again, Padmini.
They have summoned. Apparently, they've summoned. Oh, what is this like?
When you have an ambassador at your state, you can only get summoned there. You can only give them official summons, Padmini. Why are you emphasizing? Oh my God, media! Oh my goodness.
For me, summoned seems like as if, you know, it's like an order, like a king, an imperial king.
It is
king.
A letter, official letter supposed to go to the ambassador there to ask him to come to the thing, like how you... Okay, fine, Padmini.
China on Thursday summoned Japan's ambassador in protest over Japan's planned release of the contaminated water from the destroyed Fukushima nuclear plant and said that it would assess possible safety threats to food and agricultural products. Mm-hmm. That is another headline. And of course, Banujan, if you want to catch up on these news headlines that we are sharing with you today, you can go to MediaMahima.com. Is there anything else you wanted to share, Altu Baba?
Oh, nothing much, Padmini. What happened, Navalny?
I don't have an update on Navalny. That's weird. And I don't have an update on Jack Ma.
Uh-huh. How about our North Korean...
Kim Jong-un?
Kim Jong-un.
I don't have it. I have to go dig it up if you want me to go find out. Let's tell you, Banujan, that we will bring you the latest and the hottest news right here on Good Morning Bay. And since Altu Baba wants to find out about Alexei Navalny, the latest news about him, the last that we shared with you was the fact that they were going to force feed him.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So we don't know if that has really happened. I don't seem to have any update from there.
Yeah, and of course, we don't know what's happening with Maharashtra also. Hmm. Reliance, that car bombing thing, whatever was that?
Right.
It's also hushed up totally.
Right.
Sometimes you wonder whether COVID is actually a blanket.
What?
Yeah.
I don't know. Could be.
Uddhav Thackeray was in trouble. So suddenly Maharashtra went and shut down.
Well, Altu Baba. That's actually... Oh my God. Another ABCT. For those of you who don't know what ABCT is, tune in every single day with the jar. We have not yet started production on it. It's called the Altu Baba Conspiracy Theory.
Hey, it's open mind theory. Not opened, open mind theory. Huh. Can you guys start thinking outside the dabba?
Yeah, but you know what? One news item, Altu Baba, which is yesterday I was listening to this report about how the United States is going to be pulling out troops. I'm sure you shared that on the Good Morning Bay.
Mm-hmm.
From Afghanistan starting May 1st. And by September 1st, they're going to be completely out of Afghanistan, right? But now, the United States, the reason they're pulling out is they're saying that there's also the reckoning that none of this Afghanistan is surrounded by state actors who are not allies of the United States. But now the United States is reaching out or hoping that India will support them in some which way.
Uh-huh.
What they're saying is acknowledging that India, among other countries in the region, has a significant stake in Afghanistan. The Biden administration has pledged to ask regional nations to do more to support Kabul, even as Washington packs up from the strife-torn country by September 11th after a failed 20-year effort to defeat the Taliban.
But they're still going to keep their troops out there to make sure they can support the democracy.
No, they're not going to keep
them. They are. 2500 has been...
No, man, they're going to pull every single person out.
Okay.
That's what they're saying. They're going to pull everyone out by September 1. There'll be a complete drawdown. They say that doesn't make sense for us to always indefinitely keep hoping that there will be stability in the government there. So, U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken, on his way to Kabul, following the announcement of the American pullout, said during a stopover at the NATO headquarters in Brussels that despite some differences, there are some shared interests across a number of countries, whether it is Russia, China, India, Pakistan, Iran, Turkey, and others in not seeing Afghanistan descend back into civil war. So they are asking for support from India, but it's a very vaguely defined role. They haven't said what exactly they need to be doing.
Wow.
So more on all of that you will get as and when the news breaks right here on Good Morning Babe and Jam.
And That's about it for today, Balinja. We're going to be signing off right now with the Gaane Ka Keeda for you guys. Enjoy this Gaane Ka Keeda, which is the song from the movie Bhaag Milka Bhaag Maston Ka Jhund.
Have yourselves a terrific Thursday, Balinja. We'll be back tonight live at 5 on the Pan Pan Show.
Hi, this is Farhan Akhtar and you're listening to Radio The Hotties, where the entertainment just keeps getting hotter.